Hey guys, once again, welcome back to the new video. In this video, we are going to create a clean and simple text animation that is super easy to create in Adobe After Effects, and you can use this animation in many different ways. My name is Vikash, and without any further ado, let's jump into the After Effects and get started. Alright, so here we are in Adobe After Effects, and let's start by creating a new composition. So click on this new composition button, or you can just go over here and take a new composition, and this is going to be our main composition. So I'm going to call it main, and you can call it anything that you like. Set the size of this composition 1920 by 1080. Let's go with any frame rate. So in this case, I'm using the 60 frame per second, which is good enough for smooth animation. And of course, you can select any frame rate like 30 frame per second or 24 frame per second. Duration, make it 5 second long, which is good enough for one text. And background color, maybe pure black. Hit OK. Now we have to type a text right over here. So let's select the text tool by clicking on this T icon and then go to this character window. If you don't have this character window, then go to window and check this option character. Inside of this character window, we have to select our favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using this Gotham font style, and I have given a link in the description for that. But of course, you can select any font style that you like. So for this particular text, I'm going to use this Gotham Ultra font style. Let's set the size of this font 550 pixel, which is good for me. Click over here and type whatever you want to. Just like this, hit Ctrl A to highlight all, go to the alignment window, and if you don't have this aligned, then go to window and check this option align, and click on this align horizontally, click on this align vertically. Basically, we have to set the text in the center of this frame, just like that. And after that, we need an image or video clip. So what we have to do, just select this move tool, go to project window, right click on that, go to import file, and let's select an image or video clip. So in this case, I'm using this image that I have downloaded from pixabay.com, where you can find free images for your project, and click on import. And after that, we have to create one more composition. So click on this composition, click on this new composition, and this is going to be our media composition where we can drag and drop our image or video clip. So I'm going to call it media. Set the size 1920 by 1080, frame rate 60, duration make it 5 seconds, hit OK. And inside of this media composition, we have to drag and drop our image or video clip. So let's drag this image into this media composition, just like this. Hit S on the keyboard to open this scale property. Let's scale it down and fit this image according to the composition size, just like this. And then go to your main composition. And inside of this main composition, we have to drag and drop this media composition, just like this. And after that, let's make this image black and white. So what we have to do, just go to effect and preset and search for tint effect. Let's apply this tint effect and make it black and white, just like this. And after that, we have to animate this image. So what we have to do, hit S on the keyboard to open this scale property. Let's scale it up a little bit. So I'm going to set this value 120%. Select this media layer, hit P on the keyboard to open this position property, and now click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on position property at the beginning of this animation, and let's drag this image just like this, and then go to the end of this animation and let's drag this image on left hand side, just like this. And we will get this type of nice and simple animation. Alright, now highlight both the keyframes, hit F9 on the keyboard to easy ease them, and then go to your graph editor. If your graph editor not looking like this, then right click on that and check this option edit a speed graph, and then highlight this keyframe, hold this handle and just drag it like this and create a nice smooth curve. Close this graph editor and we will get this type of nice and simple animation. Alright, now close this layer, and after that, I'm going to use this text layer as a mat for this media composition. So just drag this text layer over on this media composition. Go to your track mat. If you don't have this track mat, then click on this toggle switches and select this media composition. Change this track mat to alpha mat and we will get this type of effect, as you can see. All right, and after that, select this text layer, hit Ctrl D to duplicate, click on this I button and turn on the visibility of this. Select this bottom layers, right click on that, click on this pre-compose, and let's call it bold. Check this option, move all attributes into the new composition, hit OK. And after that, select this text layer, go to character window, and inside of this character window, we have to turn off the solid fill color. So click on this little icon right over here and turn off the fill color and turn on the stroke color. And you can set the thickness of this stroke from here. So I'm going to set this value maybe 3 pixels, which is good enough for me. And select this text layer, hold shift on the keyboard, press down arrow key and set this stroke layer just like this, and it's looking nice. After that, select this rectangle tool. Let's create a nice and simple rectangle just like this, and then right click on this shape layer, click on rename, and you can call it rectangle. Open this rectangle one, open this rectangle path one, and here we have this size. So first of all, we have to click on this icon and unlink the X and Y value, and let's set this value something around 800, height value maybe 140. It's looking like this. And after that, we have to set this anchor point in the center of this rectangular box. So select this text layer, select this pan behind tool, hold Ctrl on the keyboard and double click on this pan behind tool, and now our anchor point in the center of this rectangle, just like this. After that, select this rectangle and go to align, click on this align horizontally, click on this align vertically, and now we have this rectangle box in the center of this frame. After that, click on this text tool, click over here maybe, and type same text in capital letter, just like this. Hit Ctrl A to highlight all, and for this one we have to turn off the stroke and turn on the fill. So click on this little icon over here, just like this, and for this one we have to select a different font style. So for this text, I'm going to use this normal Gotham font style. Let's down the size a bit. So I'm going to set this value something around 130 pixel. And now let's align the text in the center. So select this text layer, go to alignment, click on this align horizontally, click on this align vertically. Select this move tool and let's animate the rectangular box and the text. So select this rectangle, open it up. Go to 2 seconds and 45 frames, right over here maybe, click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on size parameter inside of this rectangle path 1, and go back to maybe 2 seconds, so it should be on 45 frames, and let's set this X value 0, and we will get this type of animation. Alright. Now select both the keyframes, hit F9 on the keyboard to easy ease them, go to your graph editor, highlight this point, hold this handle and just drag it like this and create a nice smooth curve. Again, if you don't have this type of graph, then right click on that, click on this editor speed graph. Now let's close this rectangle and we will get this type of effect. Alright, after that, just select this text layer and open it up, click on this animate, click on this tracking, and let's animate the tracking value first. So just go to on frame number 2 seconds and 45 frames, click on this tracking amount stopwatch button and set this tracking amount value something around 20, and we have a keyframe on 2 seconds and 45 frames. Go back to 2 seconds, maybe on frame number 45, and let's down the tracking value and set it to negative 75. and we will get this type of effect. All right, now select both the keyframes, hit F9 on the keyboard to easy ease them, go to your graph editor, again do the same thing. Let's create a nice smooth curve, close this graph editor, and we will get this type of effect as you can see. After that, just go to on 1 second and 45 frame right over here and click on this animate button, click on this opacity. Let's animate the opacity as well. So click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on opacity. Just go to on frame number 45 and let's set the opacity value 0. Now let's animate all the layers. So what we have to do is click on this layer, go to new and take a new null object. And right click on this null object, click on rename. Let's call it animation 1. After that, I'm gonna parent this bold composition with this animation 1. So pick this pick whip and attach this with animation 1, just like this. Select this animation 1, hit P on the keyboard to open this position property, go to 1.5 second right over here, click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on position property, go back to very first frame of this animation and drag the text outside of this frame and set this value something around 1500 and just go to on 4 second right over here, click on this diamond button and create one more keyframe on 4 second, go to the end of this animation and drag the text outside of this frame in upper direction, set this value negative 400 and we will get this type of animation. Now highlight all the keyframes by holding shift, hit F9 on the keyboard to easy ease them, go to your graph editor and inside of this graph editor highlight this point first, hold this handle and just drag it like this and create a nice smooth curve. Do the same thing for this one. So highlight this point, drag this handle and create a nice smooth curve. Close this animation 1, close this graph editor. Just go to very first frame and let's take a look. All right, it's looking nice. After that, we have to create 3 different copies of this animation 1. So hit Ctrl D 2 times on the keyboard. And now let's create time gap between these 3 animations. So hit U on the keyboard by selecting all these 3 layers. And let's create a time gap of 5 frames between these layers. So what we have to do, just go to maybe on frame number 5 and highlight these 2 keyframes and drag it on frame number 5. Go to on frame number 10, maybe 5 frame forward in time from this keyframe and select the keyframe for the 3rd one and let's drag it right over here. Alright, and do the same thing for these keyframe. So just go to on 4 second first, go back to 5 frame right over here, select the keyframe for 2nd animation layer and drag it like this, go back to 5 frame right over here, select both the keyframe for 3rd layer and just drag it like this. Alright, and now let's close all the layers and after that just split the CTI on 3 second right over here. Just go to this parent and link and select this 2nd text layer, select this animation 2, select this rectangle and select this animation 3, select this style and change this parent and link animation 3 and we will get something like this. It's almost done and now let me show you how you can create different text slide. So it's very simple, just go to your project window and let's create a new folder. This is gonna be the slide 1, so let's call it slide 1 and let's drag all the composition and the files in slide 1 just like this. Open this slide 1 folder and here select this main composition, right click on that, click on rename and let's call it main 1 hit enter. All right, and now we have to save the project. So just go to file, click on save as, select a location. So I'm selecting desktop bold. Let's call it slide one. Click on save. And after that, right click on this project window, go to import file. Let's import the slide one file and open this slide one. And inside of this slide one, we have another slide one folder. So right click on this, click on rename, and this is going to be slide two. So let's rename it to slide two and just drag the slide two outside of this slide one AP. And now this is the empty folder. So let's delete it. And here we have this main one. So let's rename it to main two. All right. And finally, we have to create a final composition. So let's take a new composition, and this is going to be the final composition. And let's set the duration of this composition according to the number of slide. So we have two slides. So let's set this value 10 seconds. Hit OK. And let's open the slide one and drag this main one into this final composition. Let's open the slide two and let's drag this main two into this final composition. And let's overlap the layer maybe half a second. So just go to 4.5 seconds and overlap the layer just like this. All right, so it will give you a nice and simple effect. All right, and now let's customize the second one. So just double click on this main two and you can change the picture as well. So open this bold, open this media composition. You can change the picture. So right click on that, go to import file, and let's import the second image. So I'm going to use this one. Click on import. Let's drag this image into this media composition. Let's delete the previous image and fit the image according to the composition, just like this. We have to down the size a bit. So select this one, hit S. Let's down the size and fit this image according to the composition size, just like this. And now it's looking perfect. And here we have the text. So select this text layer, select this text tool, and let's type anything that we want, just like this. And then we have to change this text as well. So double click on that and type same thing. And now we have to type the same thing in capital letter for this one. So select this text layer, double click on that, and let's type text in capital letter. All right, and now you can close all the composition and go to the final composition. And here we have the first slide style and the second slide text. It's looking perfect. And now it's done. So just go to very first frame of this animation, go to full screen, and let's have a look. All right, so it's looking awesome, and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification, and also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikas, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.